Hi everybody, this is Dr. A, and I'm going to bring you the first in a short series that's been requested. So I'm going to start with blood group inheritance. So this is immunohematology. So this is about how our blood type antigens get added to our red cells. So let's talk about ABO inheritance. It is a co-dominant inheritance, meaning they are equally expressed, and you also obviously, just like everything else that's genetic, you'll get one gene from your mom and one gene from your dad. So one position on chromosome 9 is occupied by either an A, a B, or an O gene. And there are two alleles for each gene, one from mom, one from dad. So O gene is amorph because there's no detectable antigen that is produced, meaning the O gene is not coding for anything that needs to be added to the red cell. And you have to have an O gene from mom and dad, so it has to be autosomal recessive to express itself. So that's the O phenotype, is autosomal recessive, meaning that if you have an A gene from mom and an O gene from dad, so your AO, you will be type A. You will not express O, you're going to be type A phenotypically. So, but the way we determine the genotype is by family studies or molecular assays, and only phenotype can be determined by the serological testing that's commonly done in blood bank and transfusion medicine. So these are all the possible types, and I've went ahead and put in there some of the subtype, the common one, so A2. We're going to talk about more subtypes in the next video. So if your genotype is A1, A1, your phenotype's going to be A1. If it's A1, A2, your phenotype's going to be A1. This A1 expression will probably just take over. If your genotype is A1O, you're going to be A1. And if your genotype is A2, A2, then you're going to be A2. So you have to have an A2 gene from mom and an A2 gene from dad to be an A2. Or you have to get an A2 gene from mom or dad and an O gene from mom and dad to be A2. With the AB phenotype, you can be A1B or A2B. And then O, you have to have an O from mom and from dad, so autosomal recessive. And then B, blood type is going to be BB or BO. So those are the genotypes and phenotypes recapped for the ABO system. So now let's talk about the A, the B, and the H. RBC antigens and how these are added to the surface of red cells. So the formation of the A, B, and H antigens will come from genes at three separate loci. So we have the ABO gene that codes for the A or B or O genotype is going to be on chromosome 9. The gene to make the H substance and the secretor gene is going to be on chromosome 19. So these genes code for the production of an enzyme. It's in the glycosyl transferase group, and that enzyme is needed to build each antigen. So if you don't make the enzyme, you cannot make the antigen. So the antigens, A, B, and H, they all start from a common glycan. And this glycan is also known as the type 2 precursor substance. And the enzyme that you make according to your genetics, your A, B, and H, the enzymes, whichever one the final sugar is added to that chain, to that glycan base, determines your ABO phenotype. And I'm going to illustrate that for you guys here in just a second. Let's first start with the H antigen. So the precursor substance, that glycan, that type 2 precursor substance, is built on a ceramide on the surface of the red cell. Then it is made by adding to that ceramide a glucose, then a D-galactose, then acetyl glucosamine, and then that's linked in a 1,4 linkage to a D-galactose. Okay, so that's the precursor substance, that's how it's built. Okay, the H gene on chromosome 19 codes for an enzyme called alpha-2L fucosyl transferase. Okay, once this enzyme is made, it will go and grab the sugar L-fucose and add it to the glycan chain. So it's going to add it to that terminal D-galactose of the glycan of the precursor substance. And that makes the H antigen. So the H gene is present in 99.99% of the population, so we almost all make this antigen. And the O gene, or the amorph, because it doesn't code for an enzyme, there's no enzyme made with the O gene, then what it is the antigen on the surface of the red cell is actually the H chain or the H antigen, because then the last thing that's added to the precursor chain is that L-fucose, and it stops there, and so that is actually what the O blood type is. And then once the H substance is made, if you will, it's the foundation on which the enzyme that's coded by the A and the B gene can add the sugar, so whichever sugar it, that enzyme is meant to grab and add, it can is the foundation for that sugar to be added to make the A or the B antigen. The little H gene is rare, and the little H phenotype is extremely rare, so not making an H antigen is very rare. And if you come across somebody with little H phenotype, they only make the precursor substance, not the H antigen, and so the precursor substance is not the adequate foundation to put the sugars on, and so even if they have ABO genes, they cannot express them because the enzyme can't add it to the precursor chain. So, they're missing this this alpha 2L fucosyl transfer. So fucose can't be added, and then because fucose can't be added, then the A or B gene cannot A or B sugar. The sugar to make the AOB type cannot be added. Sorry. And that phenotype is called the Bombay phenotype. So they have ABO genes, but they cannot express it because they cannot build the proper H antigen on the surface of a red cell. So this is what it looks like. I have the precursor substance, so the ceramide with the glucose, D-galactose, and acetylglucosamine and D-galactose added. So this is the precursor substance. And then to that, an enzyme comes and adds L-fucose. There we go. And this is the H substance right here, and this would represent the O blood type. So if you have O blood type, that's what you make on the surface of the red cells, and that's it. Okay, and then this would be the precursor substance, and if all you make is this, you'd have the very, very rare Bombay phenotype. So then, what is A and what is B? So the A gene codes for the production of alpha-3N acetyl-galactosamine transferase enzyme, and that transfers an N-acetyl-D-galactosamine sugar to the H substance that's been already built. And that sugar, that last addition there, creates the A antigen. And the A gene creates a high concentration of this transferase enzyme, and thus it converts all of the H antigens that have made, they all become A antigens. There can be as many as 800,000 to 1,170,000 antigen sites on a typical A1 adult red cell. Now, why does this matter? We're going to see the number of antigens that are produced on the surface of a red cell, that is actually going to become relevant when we go into the A subtypes and blood group subtypes. So the B gene codes for the production of alpha-3D galactosyl transferase, and then this enzyme transfers a D-galactose sugar to the H substance, and this creates the B antigen. Now, this gene produces about 600,000 to 830,000 B antigen sites on a typical B adult red cells. So for the AB types, both enzymes are created, and therefore both sugars are added to the H substance, and the mix on the surface of an AB red cell is going to be about 600,000 A antigens to about 720,000 B antigens, meaning the enzyme that adds the sugar on the B, for the B antigen, so on the H substance, is a little bit more efficient than the one that adds the A one. So illustrated, it looks like this. So We have our precursor H substance here on both of them, and then we have the type A enzyme is going to add this N-acetyl-D-galactosamine as the terminal sugar, and that makes the type A. And then this enzyme here is going to add D-galactose to this H substance, and that will make type B. So hope this is helpful. I'm going to build and create another video coming up on A subtypes. Just be patient. I'm going to try to get it done pretty quickly, hopefully next week though.